If your utility is saying, nope, you can't have solar, you say, yes, I can, and you're not going to get any of my energy. You don't want me to backfeed my solar power? Fine, I won't backfeed. I'll store my own energy. I'll collect my own energy, I'll store it, and I'm going to consume it. Even though I'm a very large house running air conditioning and heating and appliances and all the gadgets and lighting and electric cars to boot, well, I'm essentially going to be just paying the grid my connection fee, maybe using a little bit in the winter time. No different. As long as you're following building codes and you have a system set up, Powerwall, some type of battery storage, as long as you're not backfeeding, they can't tell you that you can't have solar. If they don't want it, if they don't want your electrons, don't give them a single one. They're yours. They're valuable. You made them. You invested in solar. You should be able to keep all that energy and store it up and consume it on your own. You can still be grid tied and you may still draw from the grid, but as long as you don't backfeed, when your utility company is backwards and doesn't want a net meter anymore, say, fine, I'll use it. Have to buy a battery, like a Powerwall or something, so there'll be a little bit of investment up front, but those cost avoidances will pay for your own storage. Sound good? Ironically though, it doesn't quite make sense to do grid storage if your power company values solar at its true cost, true value. If you're not backfeeding, there'll be certain times of year where your batteries are going to be full and you'll have nothing to consume it in. It'll just be too much energy. The problem isn't too little energy, it's you now have too much energy. Where do I put it? My big battery's full, and now I'm making more energy. What used to be backfed to the grid and you'd build up a large credit, now you can't do that anymore. So you just find clever ways of consuming your energy that are still valuable to you. Don't just throw it away into a big dump load, a big resistor. You want to use it in something that's valuable to you, okay? To you guys. So electric car, if you don't have an electric car, get an electric car. Commuter cars are dirt cheap nowadays, electric cars. Give it away for free to the neighbors. Say, hey, have some of my energy. Come charge your electric car at my house. My batteries are full. I've got a lot of ideas on my website of ways you can consume energy when you have too much energy. Do something useful with it. Since the power company does not value your energy, you can value it and have it for your own. Eventually, I see all utility companies realizing the folly of their ways. They fear change. They've had free reign, they've had a monopoly all this time, and now you are empowered to make your own energy, and it freaks them out. They are losing their minds. They can't handle it. So, okay, let's play their game. You store your own energy. Once they realize, oh my gosh, we have stranded assets, everyone's no longer consuming all this energy, and we have this 40-year contract with this coal plant, or this 25-year contract with this natural gas plant, they're going to realize really quick, I am not going to invest in these big projects anymore, these fossil fuel projects that are $1 billion, and now we're stuck with these assets, and people aren't using our energy. We got to do something else. They're going to switch to renewables. They're going to switch to commercial, huge industrial scale battery storage. And overnight, they're going to value consumer solar. I promise you this. It's going to be amazing. You're going to see this in the next 5 to 10 years. Your utility company is being stupid. Say, fine, I'm just a regular customer to you. I'm putting up solar anyway because it's none of your business. I'm backfeed a single electron to you. And they'll be like, you can't. Okay. There's nothing they can do. It's none of your house, your wiring. As long as it doesn't cross that threshold past their meter on your house, it's none of their business what goes on in your house. As long as you do it right, do it up to code, but just store your own energy and it'll be good. Okay, so eventually the utilities are going to come around. 10 years from now, they will come around. But in the meantime, we're going to see more and more of this. Fossil fuel, they are freaking their melons. They can't handle it. They're losing their minds. So they're fighting. This is the death groan of fossil fuels. Age did not end for lack of stones, and neither will the fossil fuel industry end for lack of fossil fuels. They are going to end, and there's going to be a lot of energy still in the ground. Because why mine it when it just rains from the sun, from the sky for free? Okay? Here we are. This is an exciting time. So, you guys ready for this?